Alright, intro time. Hey guys, gals, friends, and pals. This is Paul Acevedo of Windows Central. Tonight I am joined on the mic by Tyler and special guest co-host Mr. Griffith, also known as Michael.
Hello.
Hey, Noel.
We are going to play some Pixel Piracy from 505 Games.
Nice.
What do you know about this here game, Tyler?
Not a whole lot. I've seen it a little bit, like, kind of in action, basically. Like, it has kind of a cool little art style that you can see right there. The actual gameplay, I'm not too sure what it is. Some type of, maybe, strategy game or something? I'm not 100% sure.
Well, it has action platforming, for sure. So okay. I just started a new game, and it asks you all these questions, and it's sort of tailoring the difficulty and just the game experience to your answers.
Yeah, I like this. This was cool.
Let's see. Sorry, somebody's making noise over here.
A metal miracle.
Yeah, it comes up with a few questions, like, so you can decide what the world will be like, if it'll be populated by more pirates or more land sort of lovers, I guess, and or if there'd be nobody around at all.
Interesting.
We'll go with more ship encounters. Then how do I remember my father? And this gives you, do I want an extra starting pirate, a special sword, or some gold?
I went with a sword.
And how do you like your sword? Does it do anything special?
It just does more damage. But what I find is the game has a sort of a system in place that your crew follow you, depending on how much they trust you or believe you or fear you, that sort of thing. So if you take a lot of damage all the time, they lose morale. If you stay on the ship without even attacking, they keep the morale high. So I thought the blade beginning was a bit of a something for them to look up to, if you know what I mean.
Okay, well, we'll give it a shot.
It's not made by the same people that made Terraria.
Same
Dark
publisher,
Six.
Not the same developer.
That's right.
100% morale.
Same publisher that did How to Survive, wasn't it?
Yeah, same publisher. How do I want to be remembered? As a fearless man or as a heroic woman? We're going to go with woman. Customize a little character here with different faces. Extreme close-up. Like this. These two angry faces are nice. You can use the right stick to set the color of your eyes. So, what we want to go with some green eyes, yeah. Gonna go with this crazy hair. This reminds me, if anybody watches videogamer.com's YouTube videos, they have a female writer, Alice Bell, and she has some ridiculous toucan-like hair at times, and so we're gonna go with that. Let's see.
That sounds cool. Sounds like a lot
of
work.
Yeah, I mean, it looks kind of silly when she puts it up all the way. You know, it really looks like one of the main guys from the Penny Arcade comic. Like, but, you know, I do respect people taking the time to make their hair fancy and different. I used to dye my hair, as we talked about earlier this week. I really enjoyed that.
Nice.
Sexy stuff.
Go with kind of a low-cut shirt here. I'm trying to pick Windows Central colors. It's, you don't have great color control over the actual outfit. Blue. And jacket. Oh, that's... Yeah, I had my favorite hair way I ever had my hair. Well, for one thing, I went to a Transformers convention, and I had my girlfriend at the time dye an Autobot logo in the back of my hair. That was really cool. It was recognizable. You know, it wasn't like 100% perfect, but you could tell what it was.
Sounds cool.
But my favorite thing I ever did was just I had it all blue with like kind of a triangle of red up at the front. That was just the best. So now I'm picking my sash. That's very important for a pirate, is to have a nice sash.
Oh, that's the all-important thing.
There we go. I did not see the option to change my name, but I may have just missed it. I guess it's not a big deal. By the way, this game has really catchy music.
Oh, wait till you get in the taverns.
The zoom level is not great for a console game. I wonder if we can zoom in or not. Can you zoom in on the PC, Michael?
You can, yes. You can zoom straight in, pretty much to the length of the book.
I want to skip the tutorial. No, we're going to go ahead and go through the tutorial so everybody can learn the controls as we do, although I have played a little bit. Yes, you walk with left stick. A stowaway. Move near and press A to attack it. Now I have to grapple over to the island. This is kind of a weird mechanic you have to go to other boats and islands. You shoot out a little grapple and climb along it. It's really cute looking though.
Yeah, that's how they all get across. It's quite mental when you've got about 25 pirates and they're all whipping the ropes. Definitely a pro tip on this is to get as many pirates as you can to begin with.
Yeah, I would love to.
That's pretty much a pro tip for everything in life, right?
Oh yeah.
Make things easier. Cost.
Shopping at Walmart, take as many pirates as possible.
Always try to have pirates around.
You can only afford to hire one at first, so that's why there was a perk to start with the second one.
Alright, when I started I had 150 cash, so I was able to buy three at the same time.
PC version's easier than the console version, apparently. Yeah, I understand the console game is a bit behind the PC game. I don't think they've done a great job of updating this. Like, they have updated it since it launched, but I think as far as their overall update plans, they're way behind. So if you want to order your crew around, you just aim the cursor with the right stick and press right trigger, and they will move over there. Can you guys hear the song on the stream? Because it's great.
Someone said it sounded really Caribbean or something.
Switch between. You can also create groups of crew members and switch between them with RB and LB.
Yeah, that's handy when you've got a couple of crew members that are useless in a fight, so you keep them on the ship to fire the cannons rather than...
Select him and press A. His name is David Welch. Inventory page. Quick weapons and passives. Use right bumper to navigate the attributes page. Sure, why not? He has a couple of extra character points. So I think I want to put one into vitality and the other into strength. I want this guy to die. Skills page. Teach him to clean the poop deck. Press the A button to see the available skills. Cleaning teaches how to clean. A letter that
sails on high. Definitely an important thing.
Enough of that. Press B to close the menu. Head back to the ship. Sure thing. Climb the little rope. It's funny how the sprites don't. You know, they don't really animate, but they just wiggle around. It's not a bad effect, actually. Press X while on the ship.
Reminds me of South Park animation.
Let's see. From here, you can build out your ship, trick it out with cannons and things. Switch to the food category. Select the watermelon and place it in the boat. Why not? They will automatically eat and drink whatever I place aboard.
That's right. And different types of food has different kinds of amounts of servings.
And now we can select our destination. Pirate, disruption of the deceased. Or we can go to an island. So maybe we will go to an island first.
Let's see here. Island is good for XP and rewards like treasure chests, stuff like that. Attacking ships is where the money is.
And by the way, yeah, I don't see a way to zoom in, and I think that's a pretty bad mistake. The people who made Terraria made the exact same mistake when the Xbox One game first launched, leaving out the ability to zoom in. But they patched it in at least. And here we got some bad guys. Ow.
Loser.
Ow, stop stabbing.
Yeah, zooming was vital on Terraria.
Partner needs to get over here and help me. Yeah, so this is a game you would need to sit close to the screen to play.
I've been playing a little bit of Kerbal Space Program, which recently just got ported to PlayStation and Xbox, and man, it's just tiny, the words on the screen. Yeah.
Yeah, I understand you haven't made a console game before, but, I mean, like, is it really that hard to understand appropriately sized UI?
Yeah, I don't know if they have to know that it's not good. Like, I mean, you don't think they ever stood back and looked at it when they were programming it for the console? Instead of just, like, sitting right in front of your monitor?
You know, it's kind of like they concentrate on the port and don't think about the end result. They're just like, okay, let's port it. That's it. It's weird. So this island is actually too hard for us. The enemies were just kicking our butts. Let's go try to fight this ship. Oh no, it's a difficulty 2. Probably not a good idea. Let's get out of here.
Whoa, that custom white name looks weird in the chat.
Oh, who has a white name? Yeah.
Homie Drew.
That ship is way bigger than us. We gotta get out of here. Oh no, but we can't. We're just gonna go fight and die. What can you do, right?
Loser.
The size on the ship doesn't matter much, it just matters how many are over there. And looks like you got. Yeah,
we'll die and we'll pick a different thing. This is harder than the first time I played, I'll tell you that.
Loser.
But I shouldn't have picked this ship.
Loser.
Looks like we killed one enemy.
You're trying to steal someone else's ship knife.
Loser.
We're attacking this thing here. I don't know what it is we're attacking. It's like a jar or something.
Loser.
Yeah, usually filled with a few resources. Now, you've got two choices here. You can plunder the ship and rake in the cash, or you can take the ship for your own use.
And, well, it is a nicer ship than ours, so maybe we should just take it. You have to go back to your actual ship to do the command, and you have to call all your people back too. Hey, a little bird just came over here and pooped on our deck.
Did you get an achievement for it?
I haven't gotten any achievements. I need to look at the list. Alright, will my guy automatically clean? Yep, there he goes. He sorted it and it fell into the water. That's nice. Okay, commandeer ship. What? Oh, move. Okay, to plunder, you can't be on the ship. To commandeer, you do have to be on the ship. Needless distinction there, but whatever. Okay, who's Skyping me? Come on, guys. Well, sure, but we want to attract who we can, a commandeer. I am on the enemy ship. Do I have to move everyone over here? Fine.
You do.
Can you jump in the water or do you die?
I don't think you can jump in.
You do die. There is... There's perks that you can get for individual people that you can let them swim. But that's risky because, well, I'm sure you've noticed the shark.
Yeah, I want to see him. I want to see someone get eaten by a shark.
That would be neat. First, I want to save. So you can push start and just save anywhere. Good feature. It also has autosave. Alright. Let's jump in the water as requested. Can I? It won't let me jump in. Can I tell my guy to jump in? He says "Arr." He won't jump in. Oh well, we tried.
Oh, it just won't let you get in the water, huh?
At least at this point. Maybe it depends on what kind of area you're in or something. So we got another ship there. Difficulty 2. We did okay so far, but... Alright, yeah, we'll go and we'll take on this bigger ship. If it succeeds again, then we'll plunder it and get some gold so we can hire another guy. That's a fair plan, right?
Yeah, do it.
Yeah, get in the numbers, get in the cash.
Yeah, Paul already mentioned that Dr. Zavoda, that there's a kind of a lack of being able to zoom in so you can actually see everything on screen better.
Yeah.
But yeah, the text above the character's heads is pretty much illegible.
I mean, like, I can see it on my monitor because it's relatively close to it. I died. Go back to the last save point. But, like, you don't really need to be able to read the dialogue they're saying. It's just flavor dialogue, as far as I can tell.
Yeah.
Okay, set sail. Why are they all difficulty 2? Why isn't there a difficulty 1? That's what I want to know. Even the islands are all difficulty 2. That's kind of not cool.
It's quite unfair.
Yeah, oh, here's... This one's only 1. Okay, let's try it.
Have you spent your skill points?
I'm not.
Check your, I think you got to press start and then go to crew, and then check your crew there. You can spend points on various attributes.
Let's see, I think there's a Y button on this. Let's find out. Yeah, okay. Let's try this. We're both at full health. You can get a ranged weapon. That would be nice to have indeed. Let's see, no points for my main guy. No, but maybe on my other guy. Character ship repair for 10. Yeah, no, we need to get in fights and earn experience, and then we'll be able to do that. So there's the island. Let's see what we can see. Come on, fool.
Loser.
Can the people that you hire, can they die permanently, or do they
yes.
just come back to life? They can die permanently.
Yeah, pretty much everything you take with you is losable,
sir,
including yourself.
Oh, I gotta watch out. My health is really low. So I wonder how I would heal. Or just have my other guy do all the fighting?
Healing is done through items on passive items in the crew screen, where you put weapons.
Right. But I don't have anything yet.
Loser. Loser.
Nest. Ah! Chickens! Oh, are they bad? Let's take out this chicken. Going down, chicken.
Loser. Loser.
I bet if this was fully updated to where the PC game is, it would be pretty good overall. Although the PC game is not especially well loved.
Yeah, it's I played it for about an hour and a half, and I got to the point where I was attacking level 5, level 6 islands.
Chess.
And to be honest, I found it a little bit samey.
Loser, loser, loser.
I know there's a plot to the game, there's a narrative, but I didn't find it, so.
Loser, loser, loser.
Story kind of spread out.
Loser, loser, loser.
I don't know, I didn't find any. It was. I know it's there, because. Well, there's a reason why it asks you, did you know your father?
I think we don't want to hit these boxes. I don't know, like I hit one earlier and it blew up on me, so I feel like but I'm trying to walk away from it and it won't let me. This is probably gonna come. No, okay, it did let me just then.
Loser.
How this guy attacked that stuff. I don't know what those are, crabs or something? Maybe we should just run away instead of fighting this thing.
So.
I'm just afraid it'll blow up and kill us. David Welch. Leveled up? Oh, and I leveled up too. So can I just... Let's see if I can get a crew and take care of us. 4 character points. Intelligence, extra health. Why would Vite... Health regeneration. Oh, I see. So health regeneration, that's a good thing to have. But so is intelligence, if it gives you health, which doesn't make sense stat-wise. What do you think, Tyler? Would intelligence... make you have better health? I guess you live a smarter life.
No, it doesn't. No, intelligence lets you earn XP faster.
Well, here it says plus extra.
It says on there extra health.
Yeah, they all have like an extra stat. They all do like one of two things, but at least on the PC version.
A little bit confusing.
Intelligence always affects like your magic ability in RPGs, doesn't it?
Learn skill, no items available. Okay, what about on my main guy? Can I learn? Yes, she gains character points just like everybody else. Okay, and what I want is really high. Well, what would luck do? Critical hit chance, and dodge speed, I don't think that's very important right now. Dexterity, hit percent, and range damage. I think we're just gonna go with high health regeneration. For now, that seems important to me.
Definitely.
You just get experience from fighting those enemies.
Pretty much, yeah.
So our visit to this island has been fairly successful. Hey, Bob Jones! Or as I like to type lately, Bojo.
Bojo?
Back to the ship, mateys.
Do I have to tell my guy to come back, or will, if I said sail, will he actually come back?
I think you can't sail until they roll it back on the boat.
Alright, we're gonna save just to be safe. Get over here, jerk. He's coming. By the way, you guys, the new Ghostbusters just opened. I don't suppose either of you saw it yet.
Of course.
Tyler likes to wait at least a year before seeing new movies.
Yes. Year minimum. I really like to have them be out there a while and fully establish themselves before I see
Being
them.
A part of the conversation when things come out is just no fun, is it?
That's right. I hate it.
Ooh, we're singing a sea shanty.
How'd you like it? Did
yes.
you see it?
It's very good. I liked it a lot. I was surprised by how much I liked it.
Good. That seems to be the general consensus. Maybe they did a good enough job of making it look terrible and getting people to hate on it that the expectations were lowered so that people would actually enjoy their time there.
You know, I personally never thought the trailers were as bad as everyone else seemed to think they were. But the actual, I mean, but the actual movie, it's just a well-constructed movie. The story is not... The story is probably, like, the weakest thing, like, the overall plot, you know? But, like, the character stuff is also good that you don't mind. Like, you really will probably end up enjoying the characters and just liking the... just their interaction. All those stupid exploding barrels. Did that just kill my guy? Oh, no, he survived. Okay. Those exploding barrels are the dumbest thing. But anyway, also, like, some people have said the ghosts don't look good. I think in motion, when you get to see them a little bit, that they do look really good. And they have this cool purple color palette. And again, this is something that apparently doesn't work for everybody, but I'm so tired of movies all being blue and orange. Like, that's the default movie color scheme for the last 10 years or so. Yeah,
pretty much.
Here, your default colors are purple and green, and that is so much cooler. Like, just, you know, as somebody who enjoys art, I really appreciate that they went with a distinct, unique color palette. And it makes it different from the original movie, which is also good, because some people want it to just be exactly the same as the old movie, you know, and they won't be happy unless it's very, very close to it. But, you know, I do want it to be different if they're remaking a movie. But not different in a dumb way, like the RoboCop remake obviously was just a poorly conceived remake for the most part, although kind of an okay movie on its own.
Yeah, if it wasn't called RoboCop,
yeah,
it might have
worked. Exactly, if they call it anything else, then people would be giving it like 7s instead of 3s out of 10, you know?
I haven't seen it. I know that's gonna shock you.
Well, I mean, it's only been out for like 2 years, so...
Yeah. Hey, to be fair, I just saw the original RoboCop, so only gotta wait another, let's see, 27 or so years for it to be, you know, nice and ripe with age.
Definitely a series of movies I've never seen a stigma about. Never enjoyed them.
Does anyone know about this and why this, like, what is the deal with the stupid exploding things? I just don't get it. But yeah, guys, I mean, like, if you haven't decided in advance to hate the new Ghostbusters, I mean, which is a terrible thing to do, but MRA types, right? Logic isn't their strong point. But some people just, you know, just thought they wouldn't like it, and that is also fine, but it's better to give movies a chance, and it's better to be open-minded. That's something we often preach on the stream.
I have a friend who's like a huge comic book fan and a huge Superman fan, and he just refuses to go see Batman and Superman. And he's already judged it and thinks
it's a sequel to a bad movie.
Without seeing it.
You know that.
So, I don't know. But I'm with you. I wish he would think that.
Sure. Like, I should just pay them my money.
Well, are you going to get it on Blu-ray?
I would rent it, maybe. Or like, actually, the best way to not support them but still see it would be to borrow someone else's copy. I'm not going to pirate it. But I mean, like, it's reasonable. You don't like the first thing in a series, it's reasonable to not want to see the second one, especially when 100% of the world agrees that the second one's worse. Or as close to 100% as you can get. But, like, again, Ghostbusters, it's a whole new reboot. It is not the same as the old one, although it is, you know, like, some of the structure is the same. But I'll tell you, the weakest thing about it, and most of the reviews agree with this, is that the villain is not super great. And I don't think it's a spoiler to just basically say that he's an antisocial, nerdy type, and so he doesn't like the world and he wants to bring it down, and his motivations are just weak, you know, like, it doesn't really work. You don't spend that much time with him, you know, mostly with the main characters. And you know I love Marvel movies. Marvel movies, two-thirds of them have weak villains, so it's not a huge deal. I'm going to save before I kill this stupid box thing.
You can save?
You can just push start and save at any time.
No, no, you can't save on the PC version.
Maybe it's just hard to figure out how, because it's not good at explaining.
Might be.
Whacking away at this thing, see what happens.
Is it like a robot or something where like if you die, then you lose your character if you die too much or something? Or?
We're gonna see if we can turn the voices down because May's being fussy about it. Voice volume. Okay, we'll turn it to 25%. How about that? 20%.
Mace is always.
That's true.
Fussy.
If it's not one thing, it's another, right? Oh, okay. No, I admit, like, does she have to say loser over and over every time you attack? Not sure that she does. There we go, voice is off. How about that? The only problem is then you can't hear people saying "arr," which they do every now and then.
Yeah, there's a lot of like pirate talk that they don't speak.
There we go. That did not blow up. So I don't even know what these gold box things are. But you can just whack away at them. My other dude should be over here helping. He's not pulling his weight. Yeah, I agree, Dark Sick. The problem is she's saying the same thing over and over. Like, if you're going to have them say anything when they attack, you have to make sure it's not too frequent. Like, the voice can't be every single attack. That's a problem that some of the Zelda games make. You know, ha, ooh, ha, you know.
Yeah, yeah.
But also, it has to be more than one voice sample. It can't only be the same one every time. I don't know what these things are that we're hitting, but it's working and they're not exploding, so I guess I can't complain. Sent my dude to attack that crab-looking thing. He seems like he's doing all right. We have 52 gold. That's almost enough to hire a crew member. I think we need 70 to hire another person because the cheapest guy was 50.
Are you really just supposed to be wailing on this thing nonstop?
It's exciting. It's very, very thrilling.
Like, is it something going to happen eventually?
Yeah, eventually I got some money out of it or something. I don't know what it's supposed to be. It would make more.
Can you pick it up?
Oh, I don't want to hit this brown thing. I'm just afraid it'll explode. But, oh well, we're hitting it. It didn't explode. Good. I think the explodey things are taller. That's all I can say for sure. Oh, yeah, there's. I guess. Are they like kerosene drums or something? These are the explodey things. Just leave them alone.
This is coming from the guy who enjoyed playing Xbox Live indie games, Adam. So
what'd he say?
You can't hate on indie games when you yourself were the one who would like peruse channel.
A few of those games were actually professional quality games, but most of them were very indie. Come on, crew. Set sail.
I always enjoyed the vibration games and then the fart simulator games. Those were always very enjoyable.
Tyler, Adam spoke highly of them.
Yeah.
A lot of replay value in those sort of things.
That's right. Had like four different fart noise sounds. He was in heaven.
Yeah, by the way, this game is available on Xbox One and PlayStation 4 for $15. Steam version costs $10.
The console.
Yeah, things. Like
it has been out long months.
Yeah, so it makes a little bit of sense. But then again, the Steam version also has more content, is what everyone says.
Right. Yeah, it's nice when they can like line up the price.
That's just a better way to handle it. Like, try to do things in a way that customers won't have a reason to complain. Like, if there's a reason to complain,
right?
Just
they're going to. Someone's going to.
Leveling up our guys seems to have helped with fighting, at least. We're doing fine against these enemies. Alright, do not touch the explodey thing, dude. Nah, he walks right past it. That's good. Let's kick some butt. I don't know, this is pretty fun. Like Mr. Griffith said, it's not really clear exactly what you're supposed to be doing other than just trying to accrue wealth. But
yeah. So it's a bit samey, which it is kind of, you know, these islands look very similar.
Yeah, they're little islands. Where's my dude? Did he die? Oh no, he's there. Okay. Yeah. Help me out, dude. This enemy has better reach with her weapon than I do. Dude, attack her. At least we regenerate health quickly now. So, that was a good stat too. Yes, we leveled up. We get some money. Let's put some points into things. My crewmate is getting hungry, so when we get back to the boat, I definitely need to feed him. Let's put 1 point into damage, 1 into vitality.
Guys are funny. I've been playing Kerbal on PlayStation 4, only kind of through the trainings and stuff. I'll say that, like, make sure you really, really, really like simulation games. Like, that's what you love spending your time on, because it's super, super deep into that stuff. And then if you can play it on PC, I still think you should probably get it on PC, because the mouse would just work better than the console
Have
controller.
Have you succeeded at any of the goals? Like, is it kind of hard to even get a ship to take off and do it?
No, I'm still in the tutorial. Like, I'm about 2 hours in, and I'm still doing tutorial stuff, which should give you an idea of just how much there is to learn. And it's also literally, rocket science. So it's kind of hard to understand things sometimes.
Rocket science is not exactly rocket science, Tyler.
It is exactly rocket science.
Yeah, you need to have like a qualification in some sort of heavy-duty mathematics to be able to do half the stuff in Kerbal.
Yeah, it's very intimidating.
Yeah, like, it looks neat. It wouldn't be any fun to me, but I don't mind seeing people play it who know what they're doing.
Right. But to get to that point, count on investing a lot of hours. I don't know how many hours that's going to be, but it's going to be a lot.
That guy needs to get over here and help. These guys are overwhelming. Oh. Get a lot of hits in on him. I just need a weapon with better range. Oh, you know what? We were talking about new movies with Ghostbusters, which again I recommend everybody see. But have you read any reviews of the new Star Trek movie, you guys?
I haven't read it. I saw that it was like in the 60s on Metacritic, which is not terrible.
Yeah, that could be worse. I'll definitely be going to see it.
This is one of those things where, you know, like, it's kind of a fool me once situation in a way, because Star Trek Into Darkness is one of the worst movies I've seen in theaters in recent years. Just completely horrendous to me. But that one got okay reviews. That's the thing, like, people didn't immediately realize its problems. It's a kind of movie where, like, in the moment, okay, the action's well shot, so you're having an okay time. But the more you think about it, the more you realize how dumb it is. It's just aggressively dumb. Like, almost Transformers.
There's some dumb stuff in it. I liked it.
Watch it again, Tyler, and think about the plot.
I liked the first one better.
Another thing I don't like about it is that Abrams prides himself on creating a realistic plotline or realistic narrative, not treating the audience like idiots by doing stupid things, and then in the film he puts the bad guy in a cell and they have a chat and he spills out his entire devious plan.
Yes.
Bond style.
Yeah, I mean, if we were to talk about the things that are wrong with it, we could talk about it for a full hour, because, I mean, again, you just have to think about it. There's... Like you said, that was really dumb of him. The fact that this guy is Khan is really dumb. His motivation makes no sense. Most of the things that happen make no sense. At the end of the movie, they give Kirk magic blood, so basically this magic blood will bring people back from the dead and cure death in-universe. Just the dumbest thing you could do writing-wise.
And
of course they ignore that in the new movie, because how could you have adventure and drama anymore? So many things.
But nobody can die.
But the point is that everyone seems to, you know, over time, although that Into Darkness got okay reviews, over time people seem to have come around on it and decided that it wasn't very good, which is fair. Because once you can watch it again on video and stuff, that makes a difference.
I like the part where they show the girl in her underwear for no reason.
Yeah, exactly. See, Tyler, you know that. So I'm going to pay this guy a salary.
Yeah, that was like the most gratuitous PG-13, you know, faux nudity shot I've ever seen in a movie.
I mean, she doesn't have a real place in that movie. Like, she shouldn't even be in it. She's playing a historic Star Trek character, but she still shouldn't be in it. Get over here, dude. Okay, we're gonna try to feed this guy.
But I'm actually like Brian. If it's a movie that I might be seeing, I usually don't read reviews about it first. So I don't read a lot of movie reviews.
I just love reviews. Game reviews, movie reviews, anything. And they don't... You know, they may cause me to... You know, they may bring up a point, and then you think about it when you watch the movie. But that does not make the movie watching experience or game. It doesn't make the experience any worse, because you don't have to agree with the point the guy brought up. You know, like, a review doesn't tell me what to think about it. Like, it doesn't tell me what my opinion is, but it may... But there's nothing wrong with thinking about different things and being like, well, is that true? You know, and so I cannot remember how to bring up the menu that lets me get the food out.
We Happy Few comes out in a couple weeks.
Yeah, pretty excited for that.
Yeah, I didn't realize it was so close to release.
We're gonna go back to town. Maybe we can get food out at the town.
It's still a roguelike, right? People are gonna think they love it and then find out they don't like it.
What I played of it was really awesome and neat. But I haven't played that much of it. You know, I only played it for like an hour.
Yeah. Well, the setting and everything are cool. I just think that if it is really a roguelike, people are gonna get turned off by that. People don't particularly love that genre.
Oh, here we go. When we are parked, at least at this island, we can get the food out and pay the guy. Get back over here and get your food, dude. And from here, you can build blocks onto the ship, so you can kind of change... I don't know exactly what the point of that is.
You can build a ship, make it larger.
Dang, we don't have any food, so we gotta buy some. Oh no, did my guy just die? Dude, get up. He's just laying there bleeding. Oh, that's not fair.
Yeah, if you manage to kill all the bad guys, he will get back up if he's repaired with a bandage.
Oh, okay, I just reloaded the save. Uh-oh, but that took us way back. Dang it. Sorry, everybody. Well, let's be honest, however far I get, it's gonna look exactly the same as where I am right now. It doesn't seem to be any visual variety, does it?
You'll be on, like, the level before the final boss, and it will be a small island with some trees in the background and boxes that you have to attack 10,000 times.
Yeah, so far we haven't seen any kind of day-night cycle.
I don't know, I'm not playing it, so I don't know enough about it. It seems like the game has some good ideas. Like, I think it would be fun to go from, like, island to island and capture things and capture boats and stuff, but I'm not being impressed by the combat or anything.
If it had a multiplayer element where you would make your own bases, your own ships and sail, and then come into other people sailing around, and then, like the Division Dark Zone, you know, it's a multiplayer environment where you can just decide to let people pass or take them on.
Yeah, it is conspicuously absent of multiplayer, because it looks, I mean, it doesn't really look just like Terraria or anything, but it reminds you of Terraria, right? And games like Terraria almost always have multiplayer. There's a lot of games like that, and so why would you have kind of that basic feature? But, I mean, you know, it's probably just a scale and money thing. It must come from a small development team.
Yeah, I don't know who the actual developer is on this.
Yeah, that would be good to know, but...
I can probably look it up.
Yeah, somebody should say. But I wonder if they've made anything else or not. So we're gonna go to town now, and hopefully my guy won't starve to death before we get there. Hey, Panjaman!
That game is called... Oh, crap, no, I can't remember. The space-themed Terraria one. Star Dust?
There's more than one. I mean, me and Royal Bob were playing one for a while that was pretty good. Like, I enjoyed what I played of it. It didn't have any real direction, but it was still a fun game. Okay, tavern, weapon. Oh, there's a weapon shop and everything. So before I hire a new guy, I need to look into buying food at the food shop. There it is. Mayor shop, what the heck is that? Okay, 2 drink servings, fruits, 1 fruit serving, 3 food. Watermelon is 2 food servings and costs 7.
Starbound, that's what it's called. But yeah, I think there are actually a couple.
Ramen bowl, 5 food
servings. Quadro Delta.
Oh yeah, what can I sell? All I have is the food. Mayor shop. Learn how to walk faster. Teaches how to cook. Oh, so there's skills. So if you want to teach people skills, you have to actually buy the skills. Interesting. Ship shop. Oh, different pieces for your ship, including cannons and cannonballs. Swivel gun. Yeah, this seems kind of grindy, but maybe it's just because I'm talking and not playing right, who knows. Just kill the heck out of that chicken.
Oh, We Happy Few is going to be an early access. I didn't realize that, so it's not going to be at the finished
game
yet.
Yeah, a little bit of a bummer. I mean, they've been working on that game for a while. But I guess they want to take player community feedback into account, I should say.
It's all single player, right?
Maybe it is. Maybe it isn't. Yes, it is. Oh, you can buy a shovel.
Nice.
Staff sword costs 400. That's expensive. I bet it's really good, though. Fishing rod. You can attack people with a fishing rod. Scissors. Isn't that kind of mean to stab somebody with scissors when you think about it?
Also, if you've got a fishing rod enabled on the character and you teach them fishing, they'll be able to catch food.
Ooh. So we probably do need to get that eventually. For now, I'm going to hire another guy.
One greeting,
and oh, I love this song, friends, move on to two. This guy was a demon
sure
god.
I found a crew. As I throw back
the music is good and the voice acting is bad. My understanding.
Yeah, that's a fair one. Alright, we got 2 guys now. We're going to feed the other guy, so hopefully he doesn't die. Don't run with the scissors. I mean, fighting with a sword, at least it's a weapon. Fighting with scissors, it just seems like such a terrible thing. Oh no, where's the other guy? Did he still starve to death and die? Or did he quit or something?
Rage quit.
See, this is, I'm trying to avoid that.
What's the morale at?
Darn if I know, man. Okay, here he is. Let's see. Yeah, he's only got 1 thing of food left. 2 hunger out of 10. Cost 20 salary to pay him? That's a lot.
Wait till you get the stage that I was. It was costing 800 to pay the squad, or at least to pay the crew.
Dang, were you actually making that much? Yes, I know you're hungry, man. We have to get food first.
Every ship you take on, you would earn it a good 500-600.
By the way, Brian, we're ending at the strict ending time tonight, so I hope you're taking that into account with the contest schedule. Okay, yeah, he's not happy, so I'm just going to buy some food and hopefully he'll listen to me. The food available is different. Interesting. Okay, now are you still gonna listen to me or have you abandoned me? Okay, so he hasn't quit yet. Get back to the boat and we'll feed you quickly. Can we pull it off? Those birds need to stop pooping on our ship. Okay, he's coming. So where's... food. Why does it say no tiles available in the food category? I bought food. Oh, there it is. Okay. That's weird. It hadn't updated. So now I have to pick where to put the food for him to eat. Excellent. Okay, get over here and eat, man. Get over here and eat. Okay, so he needs to actually eat the food. Trying to clean up the poop. He needs to look after his own health first, right?
Don't worry about the poop.
There he goes, he's eating. Oh, it has a nice little food eating sound effect. He's still unhappy though. That's not good. Pay salary. I'm hitting Y to pay salary and it's just not doing anything. It's not taking money away from me.
Maybe he's already been paid for the beacon.
Maybe because he's busy eating?
He's not eating anymore. He is cleaning poop, though. It's funny how they just kick it off and it falls in the water.
Yeah.
So I'm going to feed him some more and we'll just... watermelon. Put it right here. Have to go back to the ship after we put the food on it. Come on, just let me feed him right on the spot. Let's see how that goes. By the way, you guys, next week we are currently planning to stream a game called 10 Second Ninja X. You know anything about that one, Tyler?
I do. It is a action platforming game where you're in a bunch of different kind of challenge rooms and you have 10 seconds to kill all the robots that are in that challenge room, and then you get ranked out of 3 stars based on how fast you beat it.
Did you acquire it yet?
Yeah, I beat it actually. Well, I didn't beat all of it, but I beat the main story today.
Pretty good so far?
Yeah, it's fun. It's not terribly long, but it's fun and challenging. It'll get you a good few hours of fun.
Sounds good to me.
Yeah, the controls are real good. Like, it's fun. It's a little bit of a mix of, like, puzzles. You can puzzle in regards to, like, figuring out the right path to take for the fastest time. Then the platforming of, you know, hitting the things exactly right and making your jumps right. But, I mean, each level's 10 seconds. You screw up, you just start over, you know. Not like you waste a lot of time when you fail.
That's good. Dude, watermelon costs 12 now?
Depends on where you buy it. Different islands sell things for different prices.
Well, we've got 2 crew members now. Our one guy is not starving, so he'll stay with us for a while, and we've got 1 piece of food to give him to make things better. I guess I need to just feed him now to get his health up.
Does that tiny NES that's coming out, does that connect to TVs via HDMI?
It does.
If it didn't, it'd be ridiculous.
It'd be easy to stream those old games with a capture device.
Yes. Although, of course, if they were made by Nintendo, they'd probably try to keep you from monetizing it on YouTube. Because EVE.
Probably.
They absolutely will.
Guys, eat the watermelon. Let's save and go to another island.
Yeah, the 10 Second Ninja did this cool thing where they put out this little demo and if you played it and collected stars, it went towards the total community goal, and if people collected 40,000 stars, then they would release the game at 40% off, and that's what happened. So the game will only be $6 on launch.
Not bad. And we haven't completely worked this out yet, but we're hoping to have the developer on the stream with us next week on mic, so that would be really cool.
That'd be cool.
That'd be fantastic.
And I believe he's from the UK somewhere.
Yes. And this is someone from the developer, not from Curve,
yeah,
right?
It's the actual one-man developer, as far as I know, or the main developers.
Oh, is it a one-man team? I don't know. Cool.
Yeah, maybe it's just the main one. How complex is the game? Oh, I just knocked the enemy in the water and he's drowning. That was neat. So the actual pirating is fun when you go to another ship and wreck it or whatever.
Well, the version you're playing here, you get direct control over your character, whereas on the PC version, you just click and they go there and they attack themselves. So it's more watching than playing.
There's one advantage of the console game. Am I going to be reviewing No Man's Sky? Probably not. I think maybe somebody else at our site might.
Is it even on PC at launch?
I think it is, but I'm not 100% sure.
I thought it was a PlayStation exclusive for a while. But
there's
I could
definitely
be wrong.
A PC version that uses, you know, exclusive console-wise. You know how they do.
I do know how they do. No Man's Sky.
Yeah, didn't that get delayed because of a court case regarding the name?
I don't know if it was delayed just because of that, but it had an issue with something in your neck of the woods called Sky. It's like a sports thing or something.
No, it's a TV service.
There you go.
Sky TV. And it's not the only thing they've ever tried to do. Well, look at SkyDrive, or at least OneDrive now
yeah,
it's called.
Yeah, I read that. They seem
at the end
to
of the day, it's a
the
word.
Word Sky.
Yeah, it's just a word.
That's wrong. Yeah, that's kind of ridiculous. And they said it's kind of ironic. The name of No Man's Sky is almost like literally saying no man owns the sky or the word sky. And so Sky TV thinks they own the word sky.
Isn't that obnoxious?
Yeah.
It's like that guy last year, that Filipino guy that wanted to trademark the word hashtag.
Guys, help me out.
I don't think No Man's Sky is going to be a huge letdown, but I don't think it will live up to quite as much hype as been built for it just because it's been built
yeah.
So high. Sony has finally dialed it down a bit, but it got built up so high that there's almost no way that it'll live up to that. That too. Yeah, they announced it and showed it off for the first time too early. Like, people, the hype for it has come and gone
yeah.
as well. For sure.
Anything that can happen.
There's definitely, I mean, I don't know. Sony has this thing of like, hey, check out this game that you won't actually get to play for 4 years, but let's announce it and get everyone hyped about it. And like, I'm not sure that's the best strategy.
Definitely not. Look at that Drive Club that fell on its ass.
Yeah, that was. I think that was more internal than anything else. Just bad management.
But they were bragging it up for, what, a year before the PlayStation 4 launched?
Oh, were they?
Yeah, it was supposed to be a launch title, huh? And be a launch title on PlayStation Plus, yeah, that's
right.
Did
they shut down the developer recently, or lay off most of the staff or something?
I think they closed down the whole studio.
Yeah, that's a shame.
It always is.
It's also a shame racing games just aren't quite as popular as they used to be. For a while there were lots of racing games. Now there's not that many that aren't made by Codemasters.
Yeah, they're not terribly popular. Crackdown 3 has talked about that with Microsoft's version of taking forever on an exclusive.
Yeah, at least, I mean, they're not talking about it right now. They're keeping quiet now that it's...
Right, they have almost intentionally said, like, hey, we're kind of working on it quietly, but that don't have anything to show right now.
So, it looks like the best way to do this, making money-wise, is to just win at Pirate Battles, and we're doing pretty well with that. Also, I have found what looks like a boss encounter. It's marked on the map by a skull. The map is pretty bad in that it keeps these dumb clouds around... just like everywhere, so it makes navigating kind of hard. At any moment you can only kind of see a little bit of where you can go. But I don't know if I should go back and buy more food. I guess I should. Looks like Angel Kisses and No Time for Games are discussing QuakeCon. He's coming to QuakeCon with us, so we're excited about that.
Yeah, I heard that. That's cool.
Yeah, normally the fog of war goes away after you reach somewhere. Here it is always surrounding anything beyond your basic local radius. That's not good.
There's a fog of war in this game?
Well, I mean, if you look at the map, there's fog around.
Oh, it's not a map.
Oh, I see. Here, when you're looking at your crew manifest, that's where you assign them to a group. So now I've got a green guy and a red guy.
Hey, yeah, when you get to the stage where you've got about 15 crew members, and you've pretty much destroyed a lot of ships, and you've salvaged what you can, and you've built, a three-tiered ship with at least 6 guns, that's when it starts becoming, well, a proper dramatic fight.
We just hired an archer. See how he does for us. Got 118 left. I kind of want to try to buy, I mean, let's see how much something for the ship like that would even cost. Basic cannon, 80. I guess we should get a cannon, right?
Cannons do help. You can take out a ship without even boarding it.
That'll be neat. Let's see how that goes. Do you have to buy ammo?
Not that I did. I didn't have to.
Okay, you can buy different kinds of food here. I've got enough to buy watermelon, it looks like, and that's it. Well,
I found sea biscuits to be the best. They had like 10 uses.
Nice. Yeah, those are not currently available. I guess I'll buy some sauerkraut. That's 3 food servings. No, just buy another one. Okay, that's good enough for now. So hey, at least we're finally making progress. It took me a little while to get the hang of things, didn't it? At this point, I am in favor of the game. I'm enjoying it. Unlike Tyler, who's just a negative Nancy.
Hey, I'm a middle of the road Mark. It's Adam. It's the negative man.
Yeah, good idea, Bojo. Save. He's right. Things are going well. We want to save. I have not earned even one achievement yet. I wonder what they are.
Are you sure you don't have notifications
off? Yeah, I'm
off?
Sure. That's true. If Bob Jones wasn't here, there would be no saving going on. Oh wait, we're gonna edit the ship and activate the cannon. Basic cannon, slow long-range AoE damage. So I guess I want to have it on the front of the ship, or do I want to have it on the top? I can't tell.
You're on the front. I think you need to have a cannon, there's a certain kind of fencing that you put in to hold
what?
A cannon.
Are you serious?
You probably already got it on the blocks.
Deck wood cannon window used to provide the wood cannon window used to provide the. So I've got either deck wood cannon window or just wood cannon window. I guess deck probably.
That then denotes that you've got to get it on the deck there.
All right, I put one by it. We'll see. If... Yeah, I don't even know. Do I want to have maybe a block in front of it?
I don't think it makes a difference, or at least it didn't for me.
Well, I'm trying to see if we can walk on this wood block I just placed. It looks like it may just be a background thing. Yeah, it's just sticking out of the front for no purpose. Oh well. That went okay, now let's go back to an island. Snap to Prospect Park. That's just decoration, says Adam. All of a sudden, Adam is our resident pixel piracy expert.
So you don't need the cannon window thing? You don't need that?
It looks like probably not.
Cool.
Did I mention I've got a fleet of guys on my team now? So how many guys do you have on your squad, your crew? Yeah.
23.
Damn. Do they all come with you at the same time?
No, I've got guys that stay on the boat and guys that go off to the boat. And also guys that are there just for shipbuilding or repairing.
That's neat. Yeah, because you can assign them to different groups, right? So.
Yeah, and I've got one guy I've renamed Sloppy, and he is the only guy that cleans my ship of poop.
That's funny, Sloppy. I'm going to let my little dudes fight so they get some experience, especially the new guys, so they don't get killed. Oh, guys, kill this dude. He's trying to scare me. Why are you spearing me, bro? Woo! Cut him to pieces.
Adam says he's gonna stream Zelda 2 from his new NES Mini.
He's playing a new one too?
Said nice. He was.
I was gonna say, what, Adam buying a new piece of electronics? But then again, it's a new retro thing. A new old thing.
Yeah.
I'm actually getting it for Mrs.
I don't count it as new.
I plan to get one as well. Also, I know someone I would like to give it as a gift. So the price is right, and just the quantity of software you get. Even if they only like, say, I don't know, three or four of the games, that's enough to justify it. And you have all three Super Mario games, so how could they not like those?
Well, that's the only reason she wants it.
They're fine games.
Yeah, to be honest, I'm quite shocked that it's coming out after all these years. People looking on eBay and Amazon for a Nintendo, a Super Nintendo, and there's none around. You know, finally, Nintendo are looking at that. It shocked me.
One of our guys is red. That's not good, is it? Oh no, because I signed him to the red team, that's right. He's still only level 1.
There's a perk that you can get where they stay on the ship and they gain experience for just staying there, rather than attacking.
Buy that.
But what you find is that's good for leveling up low-level characters, but as you get higher and higher, you'll be able to buy crew that are already high level.
Yeah, that would be nice. One of these guys was an archer, but he doesn't seem to come with a bow. He's still just fighting with a melee weapon.
Take his melee weapon off him.
But then would he have a bow? I mean, he may just not have one. Let's have a look.
Alright, if you've given him a bow, then he'll just use that then.
Yeah, that looks ranged. We simply don't own any bows. That seems to be the current situation. So my high level guy, I need to keep him at the back and let the lower level guys fight, right? So, that's what I'll do. Green group, you come with me. Red guy, you can just stay behind us. So we get into trouble. Being able to control the groups independently like that is good. I like it. Kill us some chickens. Ah, there's like a rat or an otter or something. The red guy's just coming over on his own though. I don't think he's supposed to be that.
Definitely is.
Yeah, it's Tyler's fault that we've just left the EU.
Nah, it wasn't my fault. Did you vote for that or against that?
No, I voted in.
You did the right thing, man. It's a shame it didn't work out. They can undo that, can't they? Eventually. It can be another vote.
Nah, not with who's in charge now.
I mean, down the line it might change. It won't change in the near future.
I think just, you know, over the years, they hopefully will see that it was the wrong way to go, and yeah, then they'll get new leadership and just have a change of heart. We don't know that. Lightspeed Halo's talking about Rob the Robot. I had a friend who actually had that. A neat looking but pointless accessory, apparently created so that Toys R Us would stock it. If I understand correctly. It's not letting us pick this at sale. Oh, now I can. So, let's go fight some pirates.
Do I have to assign a guy to the cannon?
I believe if you... First off, you need to have them have the ability to use cannons.
Well, I got maniac. What does that even mean? The skill description, maniac. Ship repair. Oh, that's neat. If you make someone first mate, they can replace you after death, so you don't have to just continue. It's different. How's this guy doing? He's leveling up too. Let's save. Oh, can't save during a fight. That's okay. We saved a minute ago, didn't we? Send them down to fight the captain guy. That might not be good. Guys, help me. Oh no, no, I got knocked overboard. No, I'm just sinking. I can't swim. No, my god. Oh, I didn't die. Okay, I respawned.
Yeah. Oh, goodness. You got knocked quite heavily far.
Yep, it was a big blow. Oh, I just knocked an enemy off. No, one of my guys just jumped off. Please don't die, guy. It does look like we lost a crew member. That's not acceptable, so let's load. But man, I'm digging the music.
Like your guy jumped off there to follow the guy that you knocked off.
Something like that. It wasn't cool, whatever the case.
Don't forget to get the loot there in the underside.
I restarted the save. I wasn't gonna accept losing a guy.
Alright.
Good, and this time it gave us a simpler enemy to it, or a simpler boat. But what do? You're fighting near the edge. You get knocked off. It's not good.
I tried to send my guys into the bottom of the ship so they can't get knocked off.
That makes sense.
When you start buying flintlock pistols, they have a fair bit of kick to them, so when you get on there, you know, you can just knock, well, there you go, you just knock that guy off there.
Alright, I'm gonna let them guess we killed the enemy. Is there anything else we can get here? Nope. So let's go back and plunder. The word plunder makes me think of Captain Planet. Anybody ever watch that?
I watched it, but I don't remember the word plunder.
There was an enemy named Luton Plunder. Yeah. All the enemies had really punny, obvious names. They're like, I was born to be a bad guy. The entirety of my
life. Probably San Diego is the same way.
But still, that name is kind of memorable in its way. This one guy is just not leveling up. He needs to get with the program.
You're not taking him off the ship?
No, I sent him over there. I think maybe the other guy... You know, do I have to send only the weaker guy, period? Maybe I can go back to an island by a skill.
Yeah, that skill that... I can't remember what it's called. It's like... something to do with sailing. They've all got various names, but it's something specifically to do with sailing. And while he's on the ship, while you are sailing from place to place, he gains experience.
No Time for Games hates Captain Planet, he says.
Yeah, he's hating on Captain
Planet.
Yeah, I mean, it's not, like, offensive. I never thought. Like, you know, it wasn't the best cartoon ever, but I don't know why people hate it.
It is one of those things where if you think about it, it's dumb. Like, it's trying to do a good thing.
Yeah, it's dumb. It's a lot dumber than, like, a lot of comic book hero type stuff.
I mean, just the way the enemies only want to hurt the environment, and they don't have any believable or understandable goals, you know? World domination, yeah. You understand. They want to be leaders. They want to control people. Just being like, boy, I want the air to not be clean. Just doesn't make any sense. Yeah, the name of that particular enemy is China.
Good, It's good for their pollution company that they own, or their pollution cleaning company. Oh, maybe or something.
So. My favorite cartoon was Mercs.
Mercs? I don't know if I ever saw that.
Nope. Yeah, never heard of it.
Could be a British only show, or a UK only show, I mean, or like one with a different name, maybe, internationally. Ninja Turtles, that had a different name over there.
Yeah, it was called Hero Turtles. Yeah,
that's so weird. I don't know. Like, where does Ninja even get stigmatized? It's not like UK had a problem with ninjas running around killing people or something, you know? It doesn't make any sense.
It's just the word itself. If it feels offensive, then PC friendly, all that sort of rubbish.
Huh.
Alright, I was finally able to increase this guy's points a little bit. Guys, if you keep, no, he didn't level up. There should be an icon on their character select thing that tells you they've leveled up. I don't think there is. Like, I mean, you can see what their current level is. No, maybe you can. I don't know. Let's see what happens after I apply these points. Yeah, okay, there is. I'm sorry. There's a number at the top left corner of the character's thing on the manifest. My main guy. Increased strength and health thing. So, I mean, building up your characters is fun. Still, there does need to be more story stuff. Let's set sail for adventure. Back to the town of Dog Creek. That's a nice place. We're getting towards the end of this stream. We did have to go a little shorter tonight due to some technical problems at the beginning. Sorry about that, everyone.
Well, before you end this, then, how much ship building equipment do you have?
I will have to go look. You want me to look right now?
See what kind of crazy ship you could build.
I've got wood block and half wood block. So
that's.
I can at least put this wood block down. I wanted to extend the length of the ship, so there we go. And then I could put the half wood block on the front, just so it has kind of a cool shape. Yeah, there we go. So the ability to change the shape of your ship is neat. It's nothing special or anything, but let's see. Ew! Food? I've got crap. Pirate crap needs to be cleaned. Why would I even have that in my inventory? That's weird, but I've got to buy some food. And we've got 174. I don't think we're going to recruit anybody new. Maybe we'll just buy a weapon, but let's look at the food shop first. Oh yeah, and that skill we talked about. Passive leveling. There's sea biscuits. 24 for 4 food servings. Sauerkraut, 3 for 17. Ramen, 5.
It's a lot harder here, isn't it? On the PC version, everything is a lot easier.
This is complicated. Watermelon, 2.
I feel like if you turn hard mode on or something, you play this in hard mode?
The lowest difficulty I could pick was normal, and that's what I picked. Rum. Is there any point of having drinks? Like, you can. Rum is classified as drink.
It makes. Yeah, it makes them a little bit more powerful, but it also makes them drunk.
Yeah, we'll just go with food. Okay. Let's go look at the mayor's shop and what skills we can buy. Oh, what did I just attack? Some little animal. Teach a pirate how to swim.
Yeah, do that so someone can get. Eat a shark.
It looks like it'd be good to have just to prevent them from dying. Teach how to read maps. Map reading. Okay, I'm not sure why we need that, but it does sound like a good skill. How to clean. We already have a cleaner. Ranged weapon range. Recovers life of crew while sailing. Dr. Aura.
Yeah, I have that one. I have 3 of my guys with that.
Cannon mastery.
My chair makes hideous
more noise. Gold from plundering ships. I think that is something everyone needs to learn, so I'm gonna buy 2 of them and buy the doctor from the other one. Elixir instantly heals 20% of HP. Huh. Counterattacks enemy when attacked. Man, that's pretty good too. I'll go with doctor for now. So I got all these skills. Let's see
well, that's
how
cool.
Teaching them goes.
Well done to all tonight's winners. Well done there.
Learn skill. So do I want my guy who has... He's the highest level guy. Do I want him to be the doctor? Does it matter who it is?
I don't think it matters.
I'm gonna let him be the doctor.
It might have a stat that sort of increases the amount of healing done, but it's not made apparent.
Okay, this guy, he knows sailing, improves sailing speed, but we are also going to teach him. Oh, I should have taught the other guy plunder, right? The guy who's most likely to live the longest. Teach him how to swim. Let's just learn how to swim. Good. Let's go look at the weaker guy. What can we teach him? Teach to read. No, not cannon mastery, because he's weaker, so we want him to use a cannon. And maybe one other. Ship plunder work. No? I feel like my higher level guy should know everything, because he's just likely to live the longest. Ship plunder, bam. And mastery. So he's a very, very useful crew member. If he dies, we will be screwed. Alright, yeah, we're coming to the end of the stream. Don't forget, guys, next week we are planning to stream 10 Second Ninja X, hopefully with the developer on, so that's going to be a really fun, special stream. Then the week after that, we are finally going to be streaming Neverwinter. And by the way, Neverwinter is coming out on PlayStation 4. It is a free-to-play MMORPG, you know. And we're going to... This will be the first time we'll have PlayStation 4 Neverwinter prizes to give out, in addition to Xbox One. So our PlayStation brethren can get some cool stuff if they come along. We'll be giving out exclusive companions, which are, you know, AI partners who go around and help you fight and stuff. So we'll have those for Xbox One, and we'll have a different one to give out to PlayStation 4 players. So really looking forward to that. It's one of my favorite games. And you guys can see how well our guild has grown. You know, our guild, a lot of them watch the stream nowadays, which is great, and they're a lot of fun to play with. It's nice playing with the same group of people a whole lot, which is something I haven't done in a long, long time. So that's probably one of the reasons I'm so into that game.
Yeah, you're a big fan of co-op or just playing together,
yes,
or anything?
Absolutely. Like, I mean, I'm so much more likely to play a game that I can play with friends than a single-player game in general. But, you know, sometimes you only have a few minutes and you just want to play by yourself. I mean, you feel like that a lot of the time, don't you, Tyler?
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah. And how about you, Mr. Griffith? Where are you on the multiplayer spectrum?
Co-op all the way. I find it boring on my own.
Yeah, so he's a little more like me. But, I mean, like, if I only have a little bit to play by myself, I don't want to, like, talk to anybody or whatever, I'm planning to go to sleep soon, then I'll probably play a nice, simple game like Pac-Man 256. Or a Forza game. I like to relax with the Forza games. Although Forza Horizon 3 is going to have some great co-op, and I am looking forward to going all the way with that. So anyway, guys, this has been Pixel Piracy from 505 Games, available on Xbox One, PlayStation 4, and Steam. I think this is not a game that is for everybody, but actually, you know, I'm just playing having fun with it, so I would like to play it more, and it gets a thumbs up for me. I'm not into crafting stuff. You know, like, this looks like Terraria, right? But I don't want to have to deal with all that complex crafting and some of the things, you know, the deeper things. This one, I understand what I'm supposed to be doing. I'm going out, I'm building up my crew, just earning more money and stuff, and hopefully eventually we'll be strong enough to handle the bosses. And I think that's the structure of the game, is beating those four bosses. We'll see. And I'm going to look up the achievements to figure out what kind of optional goals you have to accomplish. So hopefully the developers keep updating it. I mean, so far I didn't run into any big bugs or anything, but I know they still have things they want to do to fix it up a little. We'll see. Are we cool, guys?
We're cool.
I'm cool. I'm groovy.
All right.
Hip.
And by the way, No Time for Games says that banana Laffy Taffy is good. He's absolutely right, but every flavor of Laffy Taffy is good. The only one that's kind of not great to me is grape. It's okay, but it's way plain compared to the others.
Yeah.
I don't need enough Laffy Taffy to have an opinion.
Yeah, Brian likes to play solo, he says. Oh, Mombox thought it was cute. Nice. All right, guys, we will see you next Saturday night. Remember, that's a special stream for us, so we really would love for you to plan to be there. Please come out and support us, because if we have a developer on, the stream needs to have a nice number of people watching. And please don't forget to leave a comment on tonight's article. Also, don't forget to comment on my latest game previews. I just published nice previews of Star Trek Online. And what was the other game? Batman the Telltale series? Super deep preview of that one.
Oh, that looks good.
Thank you. It is really cool looking. I'm not happy with the Batman voice. I talked about that in the preview. But anyway, please read those guys and leave a comment. That is the best way to show support for us other than being here. And we really appreciate it when you do. And that's it for tonight. So whatever you do, don't hate. Appreciate.
See ya.
I know.
Not on a whole bunch of little SOBs.